Welcome to Mutual Fund Updates. If we'll talk about an individual investor, if he is missing a term called SIP, so how SIP is playing a role? Do you think everybody should have a SIP in their portfolios?
I think everybody is a very big term to use. I think most of us need an SIP. If you have certainty in your cash inflow, like if you're a salaried professional, then there is no reason why you would not want to do an SIP, because there's a recurring cash inflow, there has to be a recurring cash outflow. That's going to be beneficial to you on two, three counts. So point one, to answer your pointed question, is that of course 80-90% of us should use an SIP as a mechanism to build your core portfolios and wealth over long term. One is because it's going to inherently bring discipline to your investing process. Second is it's going to combine saving and investing. What do people do? First they save. When it becomes a large amount, then they plan to invest. But in SIP, you're saving and investing at the same time. In real estate, if I have to invest, first I have to save for 5 years and then invest. In an SIP, I'm investing and saving at the same given day. Third is, SIPs have this principle of benefiting from volatility. Volatility is an enemy to most other product classes, but volatility is a friend of an SIP, because you're in SIP, you're investing every month. Higher the volatility, the more the beneficial it would be to do an SIP. So these are the three reasons why 80-90% of us should do SIPs.
Thank you so much, Firoze. We'll be back soon with more updates. Thank you for watching.